In this video, we'll talk about some more ways of classifying placenta. First, we have already seen that is on the basis of the tissue connection between the maternal and the fetal tissue. The second classification is on the basis of the layer or the membrane which forms the placenta. So, layers that form the placenta. We can call it the origin-wise classification also. One, the first one is known as yolk sac placenta. The membranes, and if you are able to remember that there are four extra embryonic membranes. One is amnion, chorion, allantois, and yolk sac. So we are talking about those extra embryonic membranes. The placenta, which is formed from yolk sac and chorion. That means these two layers help in formation of the placenta. Chorion is one layer and yolk sac membrane. These membranes, these two membranes form placenta. This is seen in marsupials. Marsupials like kangaroos, in them the placenta which is formed is from these two layers. The second type of placenta is known as allantoic placenta. And this placenta, it develops from two extra embryonic membranes, that is allantois and chorion. So, allantoic membrane is one and chorion is another one. So, these two layers, they would form the placenta. And the third type, okay, this is seen in case of most of the eutherians. Eutherians are placental mammals. The third type of placenta is known as chorionic placenta. And as the name tells us, the membrane which is participating in placenta formation is only chorion. So, chorion only. This is seen in case of primates. In primates, that is including human beings, the placenta which is formed is chorionic. That is, only chorion participates in placenta formation. Now, from this, one thing which is clear is that whether it is yolk sac, allantoic or chorionic placenta, the membrane which is always there in placenta formation is chorion. And the membrane which is not seen in any type of placenta formation is amnion. So these are two important things. First, chorion is involved in all types of placenta formation. And the second important thing is that amnion does not participate in placenta formation. So, these two important things which we have to remember, that chorion is found in all three types of placenta, amnion is not found in any kind of placenta. That means amnion does not participate in placenta formation. This is one way of classifying placenta. Let us see another way of classification. This classification is based on behavior of placenta during parturition. Behavior during parturition. Parturition is when the fully formed fetus is expelled from the body. At that time, how this placenta behaves? The first type is known as deciduate placenta. Deciduate placenta means when The placenta, that is maternal and fetal, both the parts are lost. That means after the baby is delivered, after some time, even the decidua is lost. So what gets lost here is decidua, this is the maternal part, plus the fetal part. Everything is lost. Then the placenta would be called deciduate type of placenta. This is seen in case of humans, or we can say primates. The second type is called non-deciduate. In non-deciduate, the maternal part is retained by the female animal's body. Part is retained. And only the fetal part, fetal placenta, is lost. We know that placenta is made up of two tissues, a maternal part and a fetal part. In case of deciduate, the fetal part is also lost and the maternal tissue is also lost. In this case, the fetal part is lost after parturition and maternal part remains in the uterus and it gets reabsorbed. The third type is known as contradeciduate. Contradeciduate. In this, neither maternal nor fetal, nothing is lost. It is only the fetus which is expelled. Rest, everything is reabsorbed by the body. No placenta is lost. That means maternal plus fetal, both are reabsorbed. So based on the behavior, what happens to placenta after parturition, we classified it as deciduate, non-deciduate and contradeciduate. One more way of classification of placenta is the distribution of the villi. So the fourth way of classification is on the basis of distribution of villi. Now, how those villi are distributed on the embryo? On the basis of it, we can call it as diffused placenta. Diffused, as the name tells us, that the villi are scattered all over. Then, second is known as zonary placenta. In zonary, there is a band-like structure where the villi are formed. All other parts are without villi. Next is known as cotyledonary. In cotyledonary, there are patches all over the embryo. So if I draw a diagram, so this is the embryo. So here would be villi, here would be villi. So there are basically patches where the villi are found. Next is metadiscoidal. And this is the one which is found in humans. In metadiscoidal, when the embryo is embedded in the endometrial lining, the villi are all over. Then, later on, the villi are lost from all other areas and they remain in one part. That is a disc-like part. And that is why it is known as metadiscoidal. So it is everywhere and then it comes in the form of a disc. Next one is discoidal. In discoidal, the villi are from the very beginning in the form of a circular disc-like pattern. So this classification is how the villi are distributed on the embryo. This one is on the basis of the behavior of placenta. Here, which membrane is participating in formation? And in the previous video, the classification which we saw was on the basis of tissue connection. How much of maternal and fetal tissue connection is seen? How many layers are separating the maternal and the fetal blood? So what we have studied about placenta is that it is a mechanical, physiological connection between the fetus and the maternal tissue. But on the basis of certain criteria, we can classify this placenta into various categories. So if we have to sum up what kind of placenta is found in humans, then the placenta in humans is hemocorium, because it is the chorionic villi which are dipped in the maternal blood. So that is one word. Second, chorionic placenta. So if we have to just write those words here, that placenta in humans, this is placenta in humans. Which words should we write here? One, it is hemochorial. We have already seen the meaning of this. Second, on the basis of this classification, it is chorionic placenta. On the basis of third, that is behavior, it is deciduate placenta. That means maternal, fetal, both parts are lost. And fourth, on the basis of distribution of villi, it is metadiscoidal. Because when the embryo was formed, it was completely embedded, everywhere there were villi, and later on those villi get confined to a disc-like area. So our, in case of human placenta, we have these four words. So on the basis of any criteria on which we are classifying it, we can list out these words. So this is how the placenta is classified. We have already seen the structures, the parts, and the functions. Now in the next part, we'll take up the extra embryonic membranes and their functions.